Dearly beloved, we are gathered in the sight of God in the presence of these witnesses to join Robert and Catherine in holy matrimony. We choose an honorable estate instituted by God. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly but reverently, discreetly and in the love of God. Into this holy estate, Robert and Catherine come now to be joined. To Catherine and Robert, you have been called to marriage with each other, and God has blessed you in this calling. And to all of you here who are gathered, we form a circle of joy and prayer in this wild and wonderful corner of creation. We come at the cusp of winter, in the season of Advent and anticipation, when the promise of new life is just ahead of us. In this clear, quiet turning of the year, summer's green and autumn's hues have fallen late to reveal the deep, simple strength of the world in all of its vulnerability and its resilience. We hold our breath, we center ourselves, and we enter into a new time. In this place, we are all each invited to breathe, to be, and to become. Catherine and Robert have invited us to share a very special moment in their lives and help create their beloved community. Together, we are here to bear witness to their covenant, which is made in the sight and the grace of God. So we're going to invite Kim forward to offer our first reading.
If I could speak all the languages of earth and of angels, but did
above others. I would only be a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I had the gift of prophecy, and if I understood all of God's secret plans and possessed all knowledge, and if I had such faith that I could move mountains, but did not love others, I would be nothing. If I gave everything I had to the poor, even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it. But if I did not love others, I would have gained nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful, or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and it keeps no record of being wronged. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful and endures through every circumstance. Prophecy and speaking in unknown languages and special knowledge will become useless. But love will last forever. Now our knowledge is partial and incomplete, and even the gift of prophecy reveals only part of the whole picture. But when the time of perfection comes, these partial things will become useless. When I was a child, I spoke and thought and reasoned as a child. But when I grew up, I put away childish things. Now we see things imperfectly, like puzzling reflections in a mirror. But then we will see everything with perfect clarity. All that I know now is partial and incomplete. But then I will know everything completely, just as God now knows me completely. Three things will last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love.
And will you pledge your faithfulness to her in all love and honor, in all duty and service, in all faith and tenderness, according to the ordinances of God, in the holy bond of marriage? If you consent, please say, I do. Catherine, do you have this man to be your spouse, and will you pledge your faithfulness to him in all love and honor, in all duty and service, in all faith and tenderness, according to the ordinance of God in the holy bond of marriage? If you consent, please say, I do.
I do.
I beg the privilege of sharing with you a few things that Catherine and Robert share about each other and their love for each other. Katie says that she loves Rob and who he is as a person. He's a fundamentally good person. She says that Rob is the best father she's ever witnessed. She notes his dedication to Emma and Kayla. He's always at their athletic events. He cooks meals for them. He loves and misses them. And he talks to them every morning and evening. Katie says that that parental bond is emerging with Adriana, too. For instance, Adriana loves bath time when Rob comes home. Rob loves that Katie is the woman that she is. She's hardworking and she's dedicated to what she sets out to do and what she wants to do. For instance, he shared a story about Katie taking Kayla and Emma out cross-country skiing. She fell and she broke her wrist and she kept skiing all day. This is a woman who won't give up. Rob loves the mother that Katie has become to Adriana. He observes that this has been a natural transition because Katie has already been an integral part of Kayla and Emma's lives too. Katie admires Rob's athleticism. She also says that Rob makes her laugh a lot. And he puts up with her stubbornness. And that she's feminine from head to toe. He loves her big blue eyes and the smell of her skin. Rob says that Katie is overly generous and gives as much as she possibly can. Katie also appreciates Rob's commitment to his well-being. It's part of his daily routine through journaling and reading. Katie says that Rob values his life and his relationships in it, and he knows what is important and what's at stake for him. Katie and Rob share that even though they grew up in the same school system in West Newbury, Mass., it was years before they connected. Their connection seemed foreshadowed. And early on in their relationship, Rob experienced loss and grief. Katie reached out, and she checked in when he wasn't communicating. And though ultimately Rob went through one of the most difficult times in his life, when their relationship was young, Katie stood by Rob. In truth, both Rob and Katie are stubborn. And their love is strong and it's stubborn. Their love is tempered by trust and communication. They give each other space to be who they are as individuals, as well as a couple. Together, they share clarity about what both of them recognize as the most important parts of their lives, their relationships with their children and each other. They have already stood by through some of the worst and best times in their lives together. Both Katie and Rob will go the distance to be present to each other, to be healthy and strong and whole for each other. And through their commitment to the integrity and the love within their marriage and their partnership, they strive to be fully present to their family too. Theirs is a love that will go the distance, and it will not be stopped or turned away. At this time, I would like Emma and Kayla to come forward. Kayla and Emma. Kayla and Emma. I dearly love you.
I dearly love that.
As you have so graciously shared this wonderful meeting,
graciously share this and with me.
So shall I share the love with you.
So shall I share the love with you.
I promise to be fair. Thank you. you my strength.
I offer you my strength.
I offer you my support.
I offer you my support.
I offer you my loyalty.
I offer you my loyalty.
I offer you my faith.
I offer you my faith.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Thank you.
community you have asked to be with you today. Of course, there are relationships and loves that cannot be here, but whose connections are already woven into your stories. And in time to come, you will encounter other significant people who will also become part of your narrative. Today, however, many who love you have gathered to form part of your beloved community. Their presence here is a sacred gift. I invite you to turn toward them now and receive their blessing. Marriage is a giving and a receiving that touches many lives. For all who are gathered here, I ask you, as members of the beloved community that upholds Robert and Catherine, will you pledge your support to this covenant that they are making today? If you do, please say, "We will."
We will.
And let's try that with great enthusiasm.
We will.
In our presence and before God, we affirm that a covenant has been made. Before us, Catherine and Robert have committed their gifts, their love, and their lives to be shared together. A new family has been created. Friends, having witnessed the vows of Catherine and Robert in marriage before God and before this gathering, I announce with joy that Robert and Catherine are from this time on husband and wife. I'm going to offer you a benediction, and then they get to kiss and share their fabulous beginning with you. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face, the rains fall soft upon your heels, and until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. I now pronounce you husband and wife, and may I introduce Mr. and Mrs. Robert and Catherine Hayes. You may kiss.